Hey everyone, today we're going to build off of what we did last week. Last week we learned how to create a timer or a countdown inside of Articulate Storyline 360 using JavaScript snippets. And today we're going to show you how to create a timer that will count up. And so last week it was counting down, this week is counting up, and how you can work with that inside of Storyline. So let's go ahead and get started. Welcome back. My name is Jeff Batts, and if you haven't checked out my website, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts, everything from Storyline 360 and JavaScript to e-learning production to voiceovers, as well as Camtasia and making your videos interactive. So a lot of different tips and tricks. Been doing them for over 2 years now. So you can go through and check out all of those. You can also check out templates inside of Articulate Storyline 360. You can also check out XAPI templates, as well as strategy templates. And then if you're new to any of these tools, you can check out full courses, everything from A to Z inside of Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. Now, one of the benefits of using the timer through JavaScript instead of the timeline inside of Articulate Storyline is this timer can be independent of the animation that's happening inside of Storyline. So if you have an animation that, let's say, is about 30 seconds long, and you're basically animating in some different objects and something like that, well, this timer can be independent. And so it doesn't have to be the same thing as what's going on. And so that is the biggest benefit of using the timer through JavaScript rather than doing it on the timeline. So we just wanted to make sure to point that out. However, you could just use the timeline if you wanted to, so that there is that. But if you're pausing the timeline, or if you're doing the timeline ends at a certain amount of time, but you still want the timer to keep going, you won't be able to do that unless you use some type of JavaScript. I have a simple example here, and I have a timer variable that's displaying right here. You're just gonna copy and paste the code. You do need to, in your example, have at least a timer variable, and this is a number. So we're not gonna display any text like we did last week. We're just gonna keep this at a number. But I wanna stop this at a certain point, or I want to display something at a certain point, like a layer or something like that. We'll get to that. But right now, I'd at least have that variable displayed and created inside of Articulate Storyline. And I'm gonna start the timer, or allow the learner to start the timer, which is another benefit of doing it this way rather than using the timeline down at the bottom. Also, another benefit is the timeline down at the bottom has to have some type of end. With the timer up here, it doesn't. I can start that timer at any point, and it can keep going as long as I want it to go, but at some point you may want to trigger like a layer or something to happen. All right, so let's go ahead and add a JavaScript trigger when you click on that button. So I'm going to go ahead and pull open execute JavaScript as my action inside of Storyline here. So let's select this drop down box and let's go to execute JavaScript down at the bottom here. And when the user clicks on the start button, so I'm going to pull up this JavaScript window. And we're gonna copy and paste the code that you see below the video here. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab that code, and I'm gonna walk you through so you know what's going on. So instead of var, it's actually better if we use, if this information is not going to change, to use the word const, like it's constant. But this one is going to change, so we're gonna name this one let. So it's just a better practice inside of JavaScript, and I should have updated that. And below, it'll have the updated code, just so you know. But right here, it says let seconds equal 0. We're gonna start out at 0, and then we're going to increase from there. This is talking to the player, so we're talking to the Storyline player, and then we're going to update the variable through that. So that's just a shortcut way. Instead of having to type in get with the open close parentheses, we're just gonna reference it as player. That's really all that this is doing. All right, so we have the second set at 0 by default, which is what we have inside of Storyline. And then we're creating this function. If you're not familiar with a function, it's basically a group of commands, different things that are going to happen. JavaScript is basically commands. You're telling a web page what to do or how to update or other things like that. So really you're just giving it a list of commands. Now grouping those commands together to say, okay, I want these groups of commands to run at certain times, that's where you create it inside of a function. And you can name the function whatever you want. I name this function start timer. And what's going to happen is every time when we create this kind of repeated, this is going to run this function every second, we basically create the function and then we start the timer in a different location. So that's what this is doing, is we're giving it a timer ID and we're setting the interval. How often is that function above going to run? Well, that function we have right here, so it's going to run that function, and then we have a comma, and then the amounts how often is this going to happen? So we have this set at 1,000 right now, which is basically in milliseconds, and 1,000 equals 1 second. And so if I wanted this to be 5 seconds, I can go ahead and change that to 5,000. If I wanted this to be half a second, I can go ahead and change that to 500. So that's how that works, but we want this to run every second because we're creating that timer. I want this start timer function to run every single second. Well, what's happening in that function? I'm gonna come in here, and the first thing we're doing is we're adding 1 to the current value. This plus equals is basically saying whatever the current value is now, add 1 to it. And that's a shortcut way, instead of having to say seconds equals second plus 1, it's just a shortcut way of doing it. So we're basically going to add 1 second each time. Then we're updating the variable inside of Storyline, so it's set var, and we have to pass in 2 different objects. So what variable are we talking to? So inside of quotes, we're gonna talk to the timer variable, and we're gonna update it with a new value, which the new value every second is going to be whatever it was before, plus 1, essentially. Now, we're creating a condition, just like you can inside of Storyline. You can create conditions that say, okay, only run this section of the code if this is true. So what we're doing is saying, if this is equal to 100, as soon as it gets to 100 seconds, then we're going to clear the interval. We're gonna stop the timer so it's not running anymore. Just for the sake of time, I'm gonna change that to 20. So as soon as it gets to 20 seconds, which is, if you look at the timeline down here, the timeline animation is gonna stop at 5 seconds, but we're gonna keep running this till 20 seconds. So again, one of the benefits of doing it this way. Now we could do other things, but we could do those other conditions and triggers inside of Storyline. Right now, we just wanna focus this code on updating that text value or that variable to one every single time it runs, or add 1 to it, basically. So I'm gonna go ahead and click OK, and that's really all that this is doing. So we're gonna do this as soon as the timer clicks, and so it's still even independent of that. So I'm gonna go ahead and click OK. Now, what I wanna do on top of that is I want to create a layer, and then we're gonna say time's up. Now that layer, I could then hide the base layer objects and so they can't start the timer again, or I could go ahead and just insert some text and let's go ahead and say time's up, or we could jump onto the next page or we could do something else, but I'm just gonna display that text there. So I do have to add on that condition that when the variable changes to 20, what we're going to do is show the layer. So the action is going to be show layer, and we're going to show that layer of times up, and we're going to do this based on the variable changes. This is one of the nice things. If that variable is changing in the background because of JavaScript, we're now able to work off of that. So every time the variable changes here, we're going to go ahead and show this layer. But what variable are we talking about? Well, it's going to be the timer here. We need to make sure that we grab the right variable here. And we're going to have the condition. We only want this to happen if the timer is greater than or equal to 20. So I'm going to go ahead and select this drop-down box and do greater than or equal to. So if for some reason it shouldn't go beyond 20, but this is for some reason if it did, then it's going to be, even if it's 21 or 22 or 23, it's still going to run. So it's just kind of a, you know, safe all, catch all kind of thing. But I'm gonna go ahead and say 20 there. I'm gonna go ahead and click okay, and that's set up. So at the end of this, when it reaches 20, it should show that layer and we're done. Now you cannot preview JavaScript inside of Storyline, so you do need to publish that out. I'm gonna go ahead and move this over and pull up my folder here. Now I'm using Parallels. I wish Storyline had a Mac version, but I am a Mac person. I only really run Windows for Storyline, but I'm going to pull this up. You can see here, it's almost done. The first time you run a project, it takes a little bit longer, but every other time that you run the project, it's going to be a little bit quicker here. But now I can double click on story.html. I can go to my timer and countdown here. And if you want to learn how to do the countdown, go to last week's video. You can click on start timer here and you can see it's going to increase. So as soon as this gets to 20 seconds, it's then going to show that layer. It's going to stop it, but it's also going to show the layer. So we have 11, 12, and it's going to count up here. And there we go, there's 20. It stopped the countdown because let's go back into that code. And it's basically saying as soon as it's equal to 20, it's gonna clear the interval and it's gonna stop running that function every second, basically. So there's 20 and then there's my time. One of the biggest benefits, again, is basically working independently of the timeline inside a storyline and being able to create this kind of timer or, you know, time the learner how long it takes them to do a specific action. And then if you're doing XAPI, you could actually pass on that XAPI statement that the person completed such and such interaction in 20 seconds. So that's a huge benefit right there if you're creating this kind of timer. So hopefully this is useful for you. And if you like my videos and you like this, what you saw here, head over to my YouTube channel, click on that like button. It helps out my video tremendously. And then click the subscribe button and the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. Again, that helps grow my channel and allows me to create more videos like this. You can also check out my website, everything. All my different blog posts are here as well. You can download different templates on Articulate Storyline 360, XAPI and strategy templates as well. And you can check out full courses, everything from A to Z on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. But that's all that I have for you today. So thanks everyone, and I'll see you next week.